Hey guys, so I'm here to do a general love reading. This will be for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus placements. As always, these readings are general, they're for the collective, so if anything doesn't resonate, just leave it for those who need to hear it, and remember that there is no gender in tarot. I'll do a you versus them, so the first energy I pull, I will call your energy, the second should be your person's, but if they fit better in the opposite, just go ahead and switch sides, and cross watchers, the same goes for you. Make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel if you have not. If you need to book a private personal reading or any other services, everything you need to know is in the description below and in the pinned section of the comments. Please have the energy for Scorpio in love. Okay, we have unrequited love. There's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. Scorpio, please. Thank you. We have friends. The most unlikely friendships can form like variegated lichens on hard rock. They create a tight bond. Okay. So your overall energy is the Page of Swords. I have the Page of Cups. The Eight of Cups, Seven of Cups, interesting. Seven and the Eight of Cups, and two pages. The Hierophant, Taurus energy. The Fool, Aquarius energy, the Two of Swords, Death, Scorpio energy, we have the Three of Swords, the Eight of Pentacles, bottom of the deck we have the Knight of Cups. So I feel like there was some type of communication going on here where a person, you know, basically stated that they have feelings, and you seem to have walked away from your other options to commit to this person. This is definitely a new thing, you know? Now, we do have friends here, so maybe this was your friend for a while, you know? And, you know, it was just, like, lighthearted. But I feel like you put in a lot of work here with this person. You might have invested a lot of time, energy, maybe even spent some money on this person because you were like just genuinely interested in this person. But now we have the Two of Swords, Death, and the Three of Swords. So it's like someone just sort of blocking it and ending things and going away. Clear separation here.
So it's like you were really invested in a person and you felt like you were on the same, wave as this person, and lo and behold, it just isn't like that. I'm not sure. This is confusing. And I feel like it's confusing to you as well because we have the Seven of Cups here, you know? Tell me about Scorpio's person. The Five of Wands. Swords, the Four of Cups, Nine of Swords, King of Swords, High Priestess, Cancer, Pisces energy, King of Wands. Three of Cups, Ace of Pentacles, the World, bottom of the deck, the Knight of Wands. Okay. Maybe what you didn't see here is that there was like competition. See, there's a person where things had closed out with that they were still secretly communicating with here. And I think this is someone that they sort of ended things with, but they weren't over. So it's kind of like they were on break, kind of, and then they came across you and you were serious, and they were just really serious about perhaps an ex. Who, by the way, ain't shit. I mean, I feel like they're walking into their own demise here because, King of Wands, Knight of Wands. It's almost like you got caught up in somebody else's, like, third party drama. And I don't feel like you really knew what was going on at all. Because this person was really secretive. Why is this relevant? Why is this showing up? Because I feel like this person's. The Tower? Aries Scorpio energy. The King of Pentacles. Nine of Cups. The Star. Aquarius energy. Strength, Leo energy. The Hermit, Virgo. The Six of Cups. So we have the Wheel of Fortune, Aries Scorpio, Page of Pentacles, the Magician, Gemini energy, Virgo energy, Ace of Wands, I just see this coming out. Like out of nowhere, there's like an epiphany, you know, that this person's just selfish as shit. That they just out here doing whatever. I don't feel, you know, I don't have any cards here that clarify like conversation or something. I feel like this is something that's being exposed. It's sort of like, you know, it's going to explain exactly why this person ghosted and why they held back. But it's also just going to make things clear to you so that you can move the hell on. And that's what I see you doing here at the bottom. We have the Wheel of Fortune, the Page of Pentacles, the Magician, the Ace of Wands. You're like, okay, I'll just go over here then. But you did really like this person. And maybe you're recognizing that it's not really even just this person. Maybe you just are really ready to commit to someone, you know. And the advice, we have the Eight of Wands, the Six of Swords, the Five of Cups, the Empress after that, Libra, Taurus. I feel like it's saying that it's time to move forward, you know, period. Don't stop to look at those three cups, you know, move into the new. There's just a new chapter beginning here because, well, this is all, you know, just somebody else's nonsense that really didn't have anything to do with you. It's like you liked this person, you did what you were supposed to do, just don't even focus on the bed. You didn't do anything here. This is just somebody who, it seems like, likes to play games with their partners. A win-win outcome is forecast. Yeah. We have cleanse. Wash your weary spirit clean and take a walk in the gladed woods. In the wooded glade, sorry. And hope. An idea like a single acorn can start a wondrous forest. These cards are so weird to read. I don't see you being that focused on the bad here. It's sort of like, okay, whatever. I'm just, I'm out of here. So I feel like you just get clarity on somebody who's kind of newer, you know, and you're just going to find out that they're not who you thought they were, and probably that your suspicions are correct, you know. All right, that's what I have for you. See you soon.